1.2% burns, is it too much? Is there a happy medium between the two? And do we need to reduce the burn tax in order to create more volume? And ultimately, what is the best route forward for Terra Luna Classic? Well, CZ Binance certainly has a view, and we're going to talk about it in this video and equally all the price action going on with Terra Luna Classic. So if that's something you like and you like staying up to date with everything going on with Luna Classic, be sure to hit that subscribe button, turn the notification bell on, and also leave a like on this video so more people can see what is going on with Terra Luna. And let's dive into it. So currently at CoinMarketCap right now, we are just marginally at 1.2%. Our volume, however, down 13.86%. And at the minute, this feels like it is a hot topic to talk about. We know that we need volume, and we know that we have the 0.1% transaction fees from Binance and a few other exchanges, and we know we have the 1.2% from the Terra blockchain. But market cap at 1.8, and we did drop to the 32nd ranked crypto. Now the price actually is staying reasonably solid around this 29 to 32 range, and if we go into the slightly more technicals, we can see some of these real support lines that I've got drawn on my chart. We can see that it has respected these. We broke through this level of support here at the kind of 2.9s, and we did test this kind of top end at the 3s and came back down. So that does feel like a real strong point of resistance up around these 3s. So hopefully we could break that through today as we go into tomorrow, expecting that announcement from Binance on the next set of burns. Now, I did a video about how much I think it's going to be. I'll leave that in the description so you can go and check it out. But, you know, roughly we think it's going to be a bit less than last week. But the overall market is in the green today, with only Luna Classic just marginally behind. Now, again, it depends what the day trades like. We know the weekends are always a bit more challenging, but ultimately, if we can come out the weekend relatively flat to where we went into, it should put us in good stead for the week ahead. Now, we got an AMA with CZ from Binance, where one of the questions, as always with these, is the burns around Luna Classic and what is going on. And CZ gives a really interesting view of the world when it comes to these burns. So we'll play that clip and take a look at that right now.
Sure. So Lunacy burning was brought up on the last AMA like this, and then that triggered us to look into it, etc. There's a few things. Today, Binance is burning all the fees that we collect from trading for Luna-C. I actually think that's the best. That's the most we can burn. We can look at this thing in two extremes. For Luna-C, we can charge 10% fee for each transaction. Guess what? No one will trade. The trading volume on Binance will be zero, and we won't burn very much. We can charge a much, much lower, or we can charge zero fee, then we also don't have anything to burn. So economically, there's a sweet spot of charging a minimum of fee so that we have high volume, so that the fee revenue is actually the highest. And then we burn all of that today. So actually the highest contribution to the Luna-C the Luna-C community, and we don't make any money doing that. Charge people 1.2% tax per transaction, we'll get zero volume, and we actually will burn less. I don't know if people understand those mechanisms or not. It's just by charging more doesn't mean you'll have more income. Very often, charging more means you have less income. So I think the many people in the Luna-C community, they think that 1.2% tax is we will burn more than the current fees that we charge. I think that's a mistake. So we go by what we think is the best. And also, this solution is the simplest. We have always charged that trading fee historically, and this is the simplest things to do.
So really interesting point there from CZ. Do we reduce the tax in order to increase the volume? And that is a big question on everybody's mind right now. Equally, does that mean people move over to the Terra network? Now, we can see that volume is down significantly from where it was. I think there's two things really. Yes, there is certainly a question mark around, is the 1.2% burn tax enough? Now, remember, that protocol is in there, so that can be reduced at the vote of the community, and certainly might be one thing that we look at. Equally, I think that getting the other exchanges on board, as we have with Binance, and certainly supporting the Luna Classic is the big thing. And I think now, interestingly, when you listen to CZ Binance, he talks about us and we and our, which is very much about him involved in Luna Classic. And I think there is, and I've always said this from May, I think there is more to CZ Binance involved with Luna Classic than meets the eye. And I think certainly as this goes on, I think more and more will come back. And ultimately, he is a big powerhouse in the space. And I think other exchanges are certainly watching very closely in terms of what Binance is doing. And I think it's very important that we continue to support, we continue to see what this trading volume is, and we continue to work through the possible means of completely getting this Binance burn supported. Now, ultimately, this isn't about landing a dollar next week, and it isn't about landing, you know, 1 cent in 24 hours. This is about building continually, absolutely making sure that the exchange is as solid as it can be and the network really supports it. And that kind of brings me on to one of the debates currently around the repegging of USDC, or equally the increase or the incremental input of USTN. Now, Edward Kane, one of the developers from Terra Rebels, comes on and says, if MMs are concerned about other death spiral, then that is one thing. If they are concerned about minting in the general sense, then their concern is in the wrong place. Many blockchains have an inflation coefficient that mints every block to reward stakers. If the Oracle rewards pool gets too low, then inflation minting will likely be revisited. Our blockchain has a seniorage mint based upon reward weight that is and will likely activate at the end of the epoch to help fund the community pool. How else do we raise money for the devs and the project? The fear of general minting needs to be put to bed. Mints are necessary and will be controlled by parameters and not by the uncontrollable market swap. So I know that a lot of people were talking about the ability to mint and that they were worried about it and we would end up in this death spiral. Again, go and understand it. There is so much that they're trying to do. They're building a reserve. So we saw that with USDD when that started to unpeg. They threw about 170 million at it and it repegged. So this resource that we have to do that, and equally the coding and a shut off valve, almost to the point where if we see a significant swing either way, or if it depegs by a certain value, then it would stop trading automatically generated on the blockchain. So again, this isn't coming next week. This is work in progress and ultimately development that's going on with it. But here we are, we're sat just under the threes. We're about 20, 24 hours away from seeing this next Binance burn. It's gonna be interesting. We're definitely gonna see, but again, you come out, we are building a nice level of support around this kind of 2.9 to 3.1 level. Do we see a move into this week? Do we see more gains? Hopefully we do. I think we're all hoping and we're all pretty bullish long-term on what is gonna come with Luna Classic. And certainly CZ Binance is getting more and more involved with this, and it's good to see. Now let me know in the comments down below what you think of all this, what you think of CZ Binance, and do you think he's involved a bit more than he lets on? That's gonna do it for this one. Make sure you leave a like on the video, subscribe if you're not already, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.